Hello everyone. Can you shut your eyes and picture people and things? Brilliant. You do not have one of the conditions that I'm talking about today. They are face blindness and aphantasia. Now, face blindness is, obviously, a condition where you can't remember faces. Imagine going downstairs, greeting your family, and going up, or they leave the room or something, and you can't picture them anymore. Even your mum. You might remember their outfit, but their face is like a stranger to you. Now, I find that I can remember faces when I see them again, but when I leave a place or turn away, then I can't picture them. Every time I see my family, it's like I've never seen them or haven't seen them in ages. So whereas most people say a brief hi to their family when they see them, it's as if I'm seeing them for the first time. So imagine how you react when you've seen a long-lost relative. That's how I react when I see anyone I know. The thing that scares me is that if a family member went missing or got kidnapped, or I just needed to describe them from memory, I couldn't. I've known my mum and nan all my life, so that hurts. My mum's a ninja, so I doubt that would happen. But still, if I phone the police and they ask for a description, how do I give one? Luckily, I do have pictures of her, but if I have to keep my phone to my ear, then I'm doomed. What do I say? Tall black lady? Yeah, as if there aren't loads of tall black ladies. Keep in mind that I see her every single day, but yet I have no memory when she's not in sight or I'm not looking at my phone. Scrabble Go, the game I play, has lots of faces with names underneath, so that helps. Even my pets are not excluded from this, so I give them nicknames like Big Belly and Lightbulb Head. I do fear that I will forget Sylvie's face as she's no longer here. Luckily, I did take pictures. However, she was very camera shy, so I don't have as many as I'd have liked. Moving on to aphantasia, it's very similar. If someone asked you to describe an apple, you can picture the shape and colour. You might even be able to draw an apple shape in the air with your finger. I can only do that while looking at one. If I'm not, I can't even describe the colour. I know they can be red, green and yellow, but I can't picture those colours until I see them. I know that they are sort of round, but I can't picture what that means until I see it. I describe things out loud so I know things even if I can't picture them. So, for example, I know that my cat has a red ball. If I'm not looking at the ball, I can't picture it, but once I see it again, I will recognise it. It is most frustrating when I can't find my phone, because I can't even picture where I last left it. Luckily, I have Siri and I ask him where he is and he normally pops up if he's in the same room with me. Or I'll just ask someone to ring my phone and they will and I'll hear it and come. Funnily enough, my hearing hasn't forgotten, so I do know the sound. So it's just the memory of visuals. If I give myself a migraine, sometimes I can picture things, but only sometimes. Even then, rarely. I think I remember a YouTuber who said that he had aphantasia. It has been a long time since I've watched him and I can't find it on YouTube now, so I don't know. It would be wonderful to know if anyone else has this condition. My brain has so much going on with it, but I would like to know what you all think. Luckily for me, I eat a lot of apples, going back to the fruit, so I can look at one and identify upon looking. However, it does mean that if my stuff is moved, I won't recognise it. If it's knocked over, I won't see it. If it's even in a slightly different position, I may not be able to see it. I'm already beginning to forget Sylvie's face. That's why I put her all over my channel, because I don't want that to happen. I know that she looks a lot like her brother, but feminine and darker, but that's it until I look at my phone. On a final note, imagine that you borrowed something from someone. That person happens to have forgotten, and they ask you if they lent you their stuff. Because I'm not looking at it, I don't know. Unless it's in my hand at that very moment, I'm not going to be able to know. Most people can say, yes, and I have put it in blah blah blah. But how do you describe something or try to visualise something where you don't have a mind's eye? I'm now having to tell people that I'll have a look and get back to them. It's so irritating because I should be able to know if I borrowed something like that. But I just can't picture it if I'm not looking at it. If you know anyone else with this condition, please send it on to them, as I'd love to know how they cope with it and what they do with the condition. If you're still here, then you're handsome and you're beautiful, and you, well, I'm speechless. I'll let you know next time I see you. Over to the pets.
Hello all, this is Sylvie. If you liked what you saw, then subscribe for more.
Hey everyone, my name's Bonjo. If you enjoyed yourself, then give it a thumbs up and share it with all your friends.
Hi everybody, I'm Jack. And if you had fun, then comment down below and let my mum know what was the weirdest dream you had recently.